Today we are going to derive equations for two typical arrangements of resistors. Resistors in series and resistors in parallel.
Flippin' physics!
We start with a circuit with a battery and two resistors in series. Because a positive charge would be repelled from the positive terminal of the battery and attracted to the negative terminal of the battery, the current in this circuit is clockwise, or up through the battery and down through each resistor. Let's label those currents as the terminal current through the battery and current 1 and current 2 through their respective resistors. Hopefully you recognize that each charge on the wire has to go through all three of these circuit elements. Therefore, all of these currents are equal. According to Kirchhoff's loop rule, a charge moving all the way around a loop in a circuit must end with the same electric potential energy it started with. Therefore, the electric potential difference all the way around a loop is equal to zero. If we define the loop in a clockwise direction in our circuit, Bobby, please tell me what Kirchhoff's loop rule equation will be.
Well, we know the electric potential difference around the loop equals zero. As the loop goes across the terminals of the battery, it goes from the negative terminal to the positive terminal. Therefore, the electric potential difference across the battery equals the positive terminal voltage. As the loop goes across each of the resistors, it goes in the same direction as the current across the resistors. Therefore, we subtract the electric potential difference for both resistors. And we get the terminal voltage of the battery equals the sum of the electric potential differences across the resistors.
Thanks, Bobby. Now, because electric potential difference equals current times resistance, we can substitute current times resistance for each of the electric potential differences. For the battery, the terminal voltage equals the current at the terminals of the battery times the equivalent resistance of the electrical load. The electrical load in this circuit is the two resistors in series. Therefore, the equivalent resistance in this circuit will be the resistance of the two resistors in series. And
everybody brought I to the party.
I think you mean everybody brought current to the party.
Yeah.
But those are three different currents.
Remember, all the currents are the same.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot. Shall we?
Okay.
Everybody brought current to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
Therefore, the equivalent resistance for two resistors in series is the sum of those two resistances. We could perform this experiment with as many resistors in series as we wanted to, and the equivalent resistance would always be the sum of the resistances. So, the equivalent resistance of resistors in series equals resistance 1 plus resistance 2 plus resistance 3 plus as many resistors as we have in series. Please remember that in series circuit elements, currents are the same and electric potential differences add.
When circuit elements are in series, their currents are the same, however, their electric potential differences add. Got it.
Yep.
I do want to clarify that the term equivalent resistance means all the resistors in series, in this particular case, could be replaced with a single equivalent resistor without affecting the current or potential differences in the rest of the circuit because it has an equivalent resistance.
Okay.
Now let's do a circuit with a battery and two resistors in parallel. Again, the current directions are up through the battery and down through each of the resistors. There are two junctions in the circuit, junction A and junction B. Now, we know charge is conserved at a junction. In other words, every charge that goes into the junction must come out of the junction, which is what Kirchhoff's junction rule states. Using Kirchhoff's junction rule on junction A gives us the terminal current through the battery equals the current through resistor 1 plus the current through resistor 2. We can then return to Kirchhoff's loop rule. However, we need to first define the directions of the three loops in this circuit. Let's define all three as clockwise. Loop A contains the battery and resistor 1. Loop B contains resistor 1 and resistor 2. And loop C contains the battery and resistor 2. Billy, please apply Kirchhoff's loop rule to loops A and C.
Okay, the electric potential difference around loop A equals zero, which equals the positive electric potential difference across the battery, positive because the electric potential goes up in the direction of the loop, and then minus the electric potential difference across resistor 1, that is negative because the electric potential difference across a resistor goes down as you go in the direction of the current across the resistor. Therefore, the terminal voltage equals the electric potential difference across resistor 1. For loop C, actually the only difference between loops A and C is that C has resistor 2 in it instead of resistor 1, so the equations are the same, just change the subscripts from 1 to 2.
Thank you, Billy. Notice then that all of the electric potential differences in this circuit are equal. And because electric potential difference equals current times resistance, current equals electric potential difference divided by resistance. Bo, please combine these equations to solve for the equivalent resistance of the two resistors in parallel.
Sure. Let's go back to our junction rule equation for junction A. Terminal current equals current 1 plus current 2. We can substitute electric potential difference divided by resistance for each current. For the resistors, we just add number subscripts. But for the battery, the subscripts are T for terminal voltage and EQ for the equivalent resistance of the electric load on the circuit or the two resistors in parallel. Oh.
Everybody brought electric potential difference to the party because all the electric potential differences are the same.
Right.
Everybody brought mass.
Correct, Bo. Now we can take the inverse of the whole equation, and because we could perform this with as many resistors in parallel as we want, the equation for the equivalent resistance of resistors in parallel is the equivalent resistance equals the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the resistances.
The inverse of the sum of the inverses of the resistances?
Yes. The equivalent resistance for resistors in parallel equals the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the resistances.
Sure.
Please remember that in parallel circuit elements, currents add and electric potential differences are the same.
Right. This is the reverse of what it is for series elements. When circuit elements are in series, their currents are the same, however, their electric potential differences add. But for circuit elements which are in parallel, their currents add and their electric potential differences are the same. That makes sense.
Yep.
Also notice that adding resistors in series increases the equivalent resistance of the resistors. And adding resistors in parallel decreases the equivalent resistance of the resistors. Think of it this way. By adding a resistor in series, you are adding resistance to the path the charges have to go through, which, no matter how small that resistance is which you are adding in series, that still increases the equivalent resistance. When you add a resistor in parallel, you are adding an additional path for the charge to go through, and therefore, no matter how large that resistance is which you are adding in parallel, the addition of another pathway for the charges to travel through decreases the equivalent resistance.
Wait, so the equivalent resistance of a series circuit is always greater than the largest resistance in the circuit.
And the equivalent resistance in a parallel circuit is always less than the smallest resistance in the circuit.
That is cool!
Now, it may seem pretty obvious in simple circuits like the ones we just went through. However, it is important to identify when circuit elements are in series or in parallel, and also to realize that sometimes they are actually in neither. Okay, let's start with series. If every charge that goes through one element also has to go through the other element, those two circuit elements are in series. For example, all the resistors in the following circuit are in series. This is because every charge in the circuit has to pass through every one of the resistors in this circuit.
Seems pretty simple.
But those five resistors which are drawn parallel to one another are all parallel to one another.
Yeah, but that is just how the circuit was drawn. Every charge has to go through all of the resistors, so all the resistors are in series.
Yep.
Okay.
Correct. And circuit elements which are all in parallel all have the same electric potential difference. For example, all the resistors in this circuit have the same potential at the top and bottom of each resistor. So their electric potential differences are all the same. Another way to look at this is that if the charges are split between resistors and then all the charges come back together again, the resistors are in parallel.
Still seems pretty simple.
I'm good.
Good.
If you look at this next circuit, it appears to be different. However, the top of each resistor, or right side in the case of resistor 4, are all at the same electric potential, and the bottom of each resistor, or the left side in the case of resistor 4, are at the same electric potential. Therefore, all four of these resistors have the same electric potential difference, and are therefore still in parallel. In fact, This is the same circuit as before, it has simply been drawn a little bit differently.
Seems like we need to look carefully at each circuit to analyze which elements are in series or parallel, and not just depend on the geometry of the way the circuit looks.
Yep.
I agree. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.